Travis Proctor.
I'm Vivian Stern.
I'm Andrew Gordon.
My name is Julie Wilkins McMahon.
My name is Dr. David Sakamate.
My name is Chelsea Laird.
So how did I feel about the Leaders Forum? When I woke up this morning around 5:30, I wasn't the happiest person in the world.
I'm very tired. It was exhausting, but in a really good way.
Not a morning person.
I am feeling completely energized and inspired.
It's filled me with renewed enthusiasm for some of the things that I believe so firmly in.
It was such a thrill and an honor to be included with some of higher education and international education's most prominent leaders.
It was exciting for me to meet so many other leaders.
I really came away feeling very positive. It felt to me that there were a group of people, all of whom are thinking in the same direction and along the same lines.
It's such a daunting task, climate change, and I think as individuals we feel that our actions aren't going to do much. When your actions are partnering with other organizations, your organization, other organization, you feel like your efforts may actually do something, and that is really exciting.
We're not on our own trying to work out how to get from A to B. We're in a group and we can support each other.
You know, when I think about why I believe it was important to participate in the CANIE Leaders Forum, what I would say is that CANIE is moving us forward as a field.
And it's quite exciting to be a part of it.
But it's also my experience that some of us are beating around in the dark. We need to learn from people who do know something about it and accelerate the progression of our organization towards, you know, some kind of meaningful action in this space.
My main takeaway from the CANIE Leaders Forum was that we as an industry, the higher education industry, have to act.
And the importance of working with organizations like CANIE to continue to push the field forward with respect to thinking of what is an intersection between inclusivity, equity, justice, and sustainability and climate.
Universities need to recognize that they contribute to carbon footprint. The other one is that they must also recognize that they have a role to play in supporting governments.
And thinking about what are ways for us to be, A, just more sustainable when we're hosting events, but also the structure of the events themselves. Hybrid is an option. And is that something that we continue to move forward?
We can actually become leaders in combating climate change, and we need to do that, and we need to do that now.
And what better time for CANIE to hold its forum than during the COP26 period?
Post-forum, what are the actionable steps that I'm thinking of taking on behalf of Percy Brock community, looking at our footprint with respect to travel?
I've offered to host a follow-up session on the topic of CANIE's choice.
Working together on the guiding principles that we can then turn into actionable and measurable items for climate action.
Developing a strategy for my institution, taking some of these principles forwards, you know, in draft at this point, to really test them out.
Looking at coming up with ideas at different levels, engaging management on top, but also looking at the different levels of the institute.
I am excited to see how they turn and form into concrete action steps moving forward.
There is power in numbers. Part of it is just offering, what can we do?
CANIE 2021.
CANIE 2021.
Inspiring.
Energizing.
Positive disruption. Sorry, that was too
much. It was great. I look forward to participating in more and more.
Let's see what we can do together.